we need is a really impressive opener.
Do you know me? I read the weekday news on Channel 7 Melbourne, but nobody knows my name. That's why wherever I go, I carry the HSV Identicard. That way, I can prove to people exactly who I am.
The HSV Identicard. Pick one up from Photographics or wherever you see this sign.
The HSV Identicard. Don't leave home without it. Look, I'm the newsreader. Honest. Yeah, sure, I left it at home.
Sure, mate.
I did.
Yeah. We here at HSV Engineering firmly believe that a new equipment should be left in the box to age and mature. You know, there's absolutely no danger of this equipment wearing out from overuse, because an HSV engineer is very canny with other people's money. Oh, an HSV, the gear we're using is 8 years older than the gear you're probably using right now.
David.
John.
You're not still working on your submission for the new ID, are you?
Yeah, I'm using my Apple computer. You want to have a look?
Very nice. A lot of work.
How's yours going?
I've submitted it. It's been approved.
This is horrendous. It's awful. Jono and Deno hanging out of a tram. Chopper shots of the Rialto. Newsreaders kissing babies. Lou Richards in a pub. I mean, he's with Nine. They approved this. John, how did you get it approved?
Good morning and welcome to Channel 7's community service. I'm an exploited cadet and I get $50 for this. If you never made it past Lego, why not go along to the Doc Bray College of Advanced Empire Building? For each enrolment, you'll receive a free leftover Channel 7 helicopter that works just like the real thing. This week, there are some great sales on. Everything from the OB garage sale or the Studio 7 white elephant sale to the slightly misused newsroom set sale. Shortly, we're expecting a 7 sales sale. Well, after the great success of last year's Wells Street Festa, Channel 7 has decided to hold an annual strike. The festa will run for 14 days and nights. The street will be blocked off. There'll be petrol drum barbecues and that old favourite, egg throwing competitions at middle management. To raise funds for their finger painting lessons, the graphics department is putting on a fashion show, and the in colour this year is still black. Unless, of course, you're off to the Christopher Skase tie sale, in which case it's green. The girls in the canteen are proud to announce that the death toll this year stands at 234. That's 4 more than at the same time last year. Now, a message to news cameramen. The equipment stripping competition ends on Christmas Day, but there's still time to even up the score, which now stands at Channel 7, 6.5, Robbers 3. Finally, the Christmas Tape Committee are holding an ego gratification seminar. Glad to see so many of you turned up. That's it for this week. Goodbye.
ESVS US. ESVS US. ESVS US. ESVS. The S.
Messius, televisio laborari ex vos. Vesta secretio lumen terribilis.
Vesta secretio lumen terribilis.
Vesta secretio pigmentum etiam terribilis.
Vesta secretio pigmentum etiam terribilis.
Vesta responsum auditoris etiam terribilis.
Vesta responsum auditoris etiam terribilis.
Hic emulatio implorari numen duos, postulari secretio lumen amplius quatordicius centina milia orbis.
Pictus magi and too soft this baby you tossed from aloft. Soon we see you bust to bits, baby you gives us the shits. Amen.
Ready, one. One. Two, take. Three. Ready, one. Two, take.
Fuck around. Three, take. Fuck around.
Two, take.
Jesus.
Ready, one. We're supposed to be professionals.
Three, take.
Fuck around.
Three, take.
Jesus.
Ready, one. Ready, one. Ready, one.
Hello, squire.
Fuck around.
Say good.
Hello.
Would you like me to fart?
Master control, TD2.
Jesus.
Telecynic.
Go, ESS.
G'day, good looking.
I think it is crass.
Seven national news.
Professional.
Fuck around.
We may have to let you go.
One take, two take.
Next up on TWT.
Jesus.
Good evening, everyone.
I'm a cock case.
Cock case. Hello, mate.
Yes, Carpet, where are you? Jean, you're missing again.
Missing again.
Operations.
The production.
Engineering.
Bloody terrific.
Hello,
Jack. Peter Fleming.
Videotape control tour.
Pretty good.
I think it's disgusting.
Fuck around.
G'day, boys.
Go away. Jesus.
It's supposed to be professional. Fuck around.
Jesus.
We'll be right back.
So, how do you want this read, Pete?
It's a network promo. So it's got to sound right. Just read me the first line.
Network, huh? An Agatha Christie murder mystery. The butler does it.
Nah, sorry, Andy. Network sound. It's got to be deeper.
The butler does it in the most exciting television puzzle of the year.
Nah. More balls, mate.
Okay. More superlatives than you can poke a stick at.
No, Andrew. Make it sound more incoherent.
Here we go. Acres of alliterative oral arrangement with increasing incidences of indeterminate vowels.
Try more of a Sydney sound.
Sydney sound. And the English language mangled like you've never heard before.
Jesus, I should have got John Brooks.
Agatha Christie is a detective in Death on the Nile, 8:30 Sunday on 7.
That's it. That's the network sound.
This man is a media magnate, so we can't show you his face on television. Morning, Christopher. The fact that he's brushing his teeth may prompt you to ask, what sort of a toothbrush does a media magnate use? Any sort he likes.
No matter how hard you try, you can't hide your happy smile. Imagine the disgrace when they grow up on your face. You can't hide your happy smile. No matter what cream you use, you'll always have the herpes blues. And if it gets a start upon a private part, you won't hide your herpes smile. You know you'll never get a tug if you've got the herpes bug. You can hide it in your jocks or wrap it up in socks, but you can't hide your herpes smile. No matter how hard you try, you can't hide your herpes smile. You can try to burn it off, but that is not enough, and you can't hide your herpes smile. No matter how hard you squeeze, you're stuck with this disease. You can pick and you can scrape, but there is no escape. You can't hide your herpes smile. You can't hide a herpes. You can't hide a herpes smile.
The year in review. HSV changes hands. February 13th, a black day for Australia. Tentacles of evil encompass the land as the Fairfax regime strikes at the very bosom of Melbourne. At Fairfax HQ, these men work to rally support among the masses.
Bein upon uns beiden bricht. Und das wird nicht. Das also lasserische Deutschland sein.
With the appearance of multiple Willises, the first in a series of vicious assaults, refugee columns became a common sight. The resistance was formed and lasagna was distributed to the needy. Rearguard action by the resistance thwarted an attempt by Fairfax forces to cover a motor racing event. Seen here is their mobile production unit beating a hasty retreat. Well done, fellas. And then, in our darkest hour, when all seemed lost, a coup d'etat led by the very nicely dressed Lord Skase and his trusty sidekick, Colonel Bob Rambooker Campbell, succeeded in overthrowing the Fairfax tyranny. Here, Lord Skase, affectionately referred to as St. Christopher, addresses his troops.
We've been, in the television vernacular, in the black for a few months, and we've really got to thump our competitors and really hit the audience between the eyes, and I think that that sort of expression and that sort of emotion is certainly the direction from which I'm coming.
A new era has dawned. The Fairfax Empire is no more, and the people of HSV7 certainly are looking on the bright side.
I'm looking on the bright side, though today's all care and strife. I can wear a grin, keeping up the chin, looking on the bright side of life.
David. Morning, John. Did you fart?